Are you interested in playing games, either on your smartphone or tablet or even in your portable media player? From the late 90s, the earliest known game on your mobile phone, Tetris, to Asphalt Extreme in 2018, a number of games came into play. Nearly 6 lakhs Android games are present in the Play Store, and 2,25,000 iOS games are present in App Store, and even more games are present on the internet. Nowadays, it is very easy to build an Android game using different Android game developing platforms like Unity, Corona SDK, JMonkey Engine, and MareMelody, and lot more developing platforms are available on internet. And above all, I preferred using Unity because Unity is a multi-purpose game engine that supports 2D and 3D graphics, drag and drop functionality, and using programming languages like C# and JavaScript. To make your developed Android game into VR functionality, we use Cardboard SDK provided by Google. Google provides two software developing kits for developing VR Cardboard applications, one for Android operating system using Java programming language and other for Unity using C# programming language. And in today's video, I will show you how to build a simple virtual reality Android game using Unity and convert it into an Android device and play it using VR Cardboard. So without wasting time, let's get started. There are many Android VR games available on Play Store. The racer game you are seeing now is downloaded from the Play Store. So once go to Play Store and check it out. In this video, I will show you how to make a 360 degrees rotational game using Unity. In the coming videos, I will show you how to make advanced games using Unity. The developed Android game is converted into an APK file and installed in your Android device. You can see the game in your Android mobile. To create this game, you need to have Unity software. So go to Unity God and click on Get Unity and Personal Free Version and try and download for your operating system, either for Windows or Mac OS or Linux. Download the latest version of Unity. After downloading, I already downloaded. Open Unity and click on New Project, New button, and give a project name. And click on Create Project. It will take some time. Opening the Unity, the software looks like this. So the first thing we are going to do is go to Edit, Preferences and External Tools. We want to download Android SDK and JDK files to convert your game into Android device. So go to Android Studios. I will give link in the description below. Go all the way down and download the SDK file in command line tools for your operating system. After downloading, extract the folder and go to Android SDK and rename the tools with tools2 and download and replace the tools folder that I will give in the description below, because there is a bug for the version and creating an error. After making the required changes, copy the path and go to Unity and paste it at Android SDK. Now for JDK, open the link that I will give in the description below and download Java JDK development kit for your operating system and extract the folder and install it in your PC. After installing, open the folder JDK and JDK 1.80. Now copy the path of JDK 1.80 and open Unity and paste it in Android JDK. Now open file, build settings and switch the platform to Android by clicking on Android and build settings. Switch platform. It will take some time. Now go to play settings. The first thing we gonna do under the play setting is change the company name and the product name. Now go to other settings and change the package name with your company name and product name as com.companyname.productname. And change the minimum API level to 19. And the next thing we are going to do is to add VR functionality to our Unity. Now go to Google VR, I will give link in the description below, and download the Android SDK, Cardboard SDK for Unity. Go to Unity and download the Cardboard SDK. After downloading, open it. And open the Unity and drag the SDK file onto assets folder in the Unity. Now to install, it will take some time. Now click on import. After installing, open the Google VR folder. It will give some other folders. We will discuss it later on. Now go to File, Build Settings, Player Settings. Now go to XR Settings at the bottom. Check the Virtual Reality checkbox and that will open up a list, and this list will add Cardboard SDK. Add Cardboard. Now create a cube in the workspace. I already created it. And the next step is And the next step is to create a game object and a material and give it a color. And drag that onto the cube. Onto the cube. Onto the cube, add a new script component. And open it. And open it in the Visual Studios. And the first thing we gonna do is create a public float variable called spin value and give a value of about 90 to the spin value and in void update function create a transform.rotate to the cube in z-axis vector 3 give means that it will move in z-axis up in upward direction and multiplied with time dot delta time with a specific time. It will give some delay to the cube with a specific time. And save the. Now open Unity and click the play button. You can see that the cube is rotating. Give a x-axis of about 45 degrees. Now click play button again. You can see that the cube is tilted about 45 degrees. Now search for GVR editor emulator and drag it into workspace scene and also search for GVR controller main and GVR controller main and drag it into scene. Now click the play button. You can see that the cube will disappear. To retrieve back the cube, create an empty game object and name it as head, whatever you want. Now click on the cube and give a y value of 1.8 and z value of minus 5 in the position. Now again click on play button. You can see that the cube will disappear. To retrieve back it, click on main camera and drag it into head and again click on play button. You can now see the cube. Now search for cube room and drag it into the scene. You can see a room inside the cube. A cube inside the room. This is predefined scene of Google VR. Now search for GVR reticle pointer and put it in main camera. Now click on play button. Now you can see a dot at the center of the cube. Use control plus mouse cursor position and alt plus keypad position to change the position of that particle. Now you can see the 360 degrees rotation of the entire room and the cube. Now click on file, build settings, and click on build and give a name to the file and click save. Now you can create an APK file of this game. After creating APK file, and copy the APK file into your phone and install it on your mobile. Now you can see the game in your Android device. That's it. You can create your first Android game using Unity software. In the coming videos, I will show you some advanced games. I will provide the APK file in my website. I will give link in the description below to the APK file. You can download it on your Android device. Thank you for watching the video. Please hit a like and share the video with your friends and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.